Alors, récapitulons. These are the facts. 3 days ago, I arrived at Popplewell Manor. As a friend of Sir Clive's late father, I often come here for a rest. The other guests were Le Capitaine Rupert Gibson and his wife Valerie. A sexy little thing, 15 years younger and a nude painter's model. Le Capitaine snaps and gives his wife a beating. Madame Sue Pike, headmistress of Pike Finishing Academy for Young Ladies. A gossip with an evil tongue. Mr. Nigel Fox and his wife Joanne. Mr. Fox is the architect commissioned with the restoration of Popplewell Manor. Unfortunately, Monsieur is an alcoholic. Madame Fox is on the point of a nervous breakdown due to her husband's drinking. She is also under the influence of her mother, whom she phones every day. Sir Clive, owner of ancestral Popplewell Manor, does not have the money for the restoration. That's why he has an agreement with the wealthy father of Lady Prunella. He will give her his title and status in return for her father's money. And finally, Lady Prunella Birtwistle, a wealthy socialite with a shady past that prevents her from climbing the social ladder. And then there's Mrs. Cook. That woman should not be allowed inside a kitchen. Parbleu, how she manages to take away the taste of even the simplest food. It's criminal. Carruthers, the butler, and a very reliable manservant indeed. Felix Nightingale, a famous painter of nudes and a notorious womanizer, is murdered in the park of Popplewell Manor, a bottle of French wine lying next to him. Who killed him and why? The butler and Mrs. Cook can be disregarded since both of them were either in the kitchen or the living room when the victim was murdered. Then who? Who had motive and opportunity? I have gathered all the evidence. The puzzle is complete. Do you know who did it? Watch the next episode, where I shall reveal the identity of Monsieur Felix's murderer.